Rich Voss is outside the studio.
I see that.
I told him to go back outside. I go, wait for your big introduction now that you're a big freaking star. Let's just make him sit out there. He has no idea we're talking about him.
Look at those stiff, non-bending fingers. They just don't bend.
We're just going to make him sit out there. He's getting all impatient. He thinks we're doing it because he's a big star. No, we're doing it because you're an ass.
Oh, he's going to hear that in a few seconds.
I know, so quickly open the door and get him in here before he hears that part. No, our buddy is outside the studio, Rich Voss. He's
all right.
You're looking good, though. You lost weight.
Thank you.
He did,
working
didn't he?
Out at the gym down...
No, he isn't. He works out with a guy named Jim in his room. You look good, though. You did lose
you
weight.
You know, he did not lose weight.
You don't think so?
No, he's just wearing baggier clothes.
No, I'm telling you.
I did lose weight, right.
He did. He lost weight.
Do you have a scale at your house, Jim?
No, I don't. For
what? He's not a complete spectacle anymore.
No, I don't. For what?
You don't have XM radio yet because you're cheap and you're Jewish.
Well, I haven't been around to get it. Of course,
a redundant phrase there.
What are you talking about? I'm not cheap at all. I'm a high roller. Armani glasses, a Coach wallet. I'm sitting with, $1,000 worth of lighters in my pocket. I'm going to go get worked on. What are you cheap? I'm a player now. You know,
you're not a player.
You're not a player. Relax.
I'm a player.
That's why you need to come into the show like once a month so we can knock you back down to size.
And it's going
to
be more than once a month. It's just that I've been on the road and very busy.
It's going to be about once a month. Trust me.
Listen to me. So you can't do it, Mr. Black? Call Voss.
Exactly.
When your book comes out, okay, call Voss.
You know when they have that guest on Letterman and you know he's only there because someone canceled last minute? You're our guy, okay?
That's good.
That's not a bad spot to be in, though.
Listen,
who canceled today? Paul Mercurio?
Yeah. What happened? He tripped on his bottom lip. Canceled.
Juice came out. Slipped on it.
He's got to be trashed.
Well, I think some of the phones already have MP3 players, right?
But yeah, they do. Using those. They use the iPods, right? Instead of the MP. Is that the same thing? I don't know.
Oh my God.
What? You know, the MP3.
The MP3 player. I listen to the Motley Crue on it.
It comes with a little needle. It's like a little record player.
A needle. You don't want it to skip when you move
around.
Is it the
MP3 player like the mini disc recorder player?
Let him talk.
Oh my God, a mini disc.
Isn't that what that is?
Yes.
And that's
iPod
exactly what it
is. What you download songs.
Yeah,
of
course.
I bought one for my kid.
Right.
There you have it.
Yep.
I was listening to the Allman Brothers on the other night.
You bought something for your kid that's probably 5 years old.
An iPod?
You got the iPod.
Yeah, for my kid.
You're talking
iPod.
A mini disc, though.
You were
where
saying
did
mini
that come
disc.
In?
They say, what, an MP3, a mini disc?
Yeah, sure.
I don't know what it is. I don't listen to that crap. I listen to,
That crap?
Oh, listen to that kind of stuff. Who listens to music? You get to a certain age, you stop listening to music.
No, you don't.
No, you don't.
Who walks around listening to music? Do any of you guys walk around?
I always
around?
Listen to music. I don't walk around it, but I always listen to it.
I have an iPod in my coat right now.
What else? What do you listen to? Talk?
No, I listen to talk or...
You're an old codger.
No,
what do you mean? He can't
listen...
I don't need it.
He can't listen to music because he's got to make sure he hears the phone ring when Bonnie calls.
Oh, that's true.
He doesn't have time to be, putting earbuds in his ears and listening to music off his iPod. Yeah, and God forbid the phone rings and he doesn't answer it.
That music is a bunch of bunk.
That's the wrong one. There it is.
Hi, Bonnie. I was listening to my MP3 player when I thought I heard the phone ring. Was that you?
My MP3 player is filled with all my mini discs.
Sorry, Bonnie. I had the Victrola on. I didn't hear the phone ring. Was that, what? Watson, come quick. I need you. What the hell was that? Was that Bonnie? This is why I don't listen to music. I can't hear my poopsie call me.
What am I doing listening to these really long Allman Brothers songs?
Snookums? Right. Oh, sorry. I was halfway through In Memory of Elizabeth Reed, and 2 hours had gone by. I was the live version.
How's Bonnie?
She's great.
Yes, she is.
We were... Well, what did she do that was? Oh, we were pitching a TV show the other day, right?
Really? Together as a couple?
Well, I'm not just saying. So, they go, if it happens.
Nick and Jessica.
No. She goes, they go, if it happens.
Yeah. What? I'm just joking.
Oh, okay.
It really is like Nick and Jessica.
I never even saw it, so I don't know what it is. They go, if it happens, who would you want to direct it? And she goes, I want Rob Fox from the first season of Last Comic Standing because he made Tess look funny.
So,
she's good in the meeting. Very funny gal. Very funny. Just saying, very funny.
I just like the way your little hands move back and forth, and you look like a midget accepting a wedding proposal.
You got to see that. Oh, you haven't
still
seen
haven't
it
seen it.
Oh,
no.
They're trying to hide her eyes like any normal, like what she'd seen in the movies, and they just keep hitting her little chin.
Oh, her chin. She can't reach her eyes with those little T-Rex hands. I believe it's on HBO On Demand or Showtime On Demand. One of those On Demand. You got to see it.
What?
Funny as hell. Right. What's the matter, Rich?
I left. I forgot.
He was ready to. He was so excited to say something. He goes, oh, and then just stops.
Yeah, I know.
You lost confidence in it, didn't you?
Yeah, complete.
Yeah. I love watching the loss of confidence happen. But it's even funny what happens in the middle of the joke.
Yeah.
Because, you know, the thing is here, like, if you know something's working, you guys don't, like, you know, you just attack.
I know. It's like pit bulls. Isn't
when
it
When DJs
awful?
Attack.
He's weak. Right for the throat. A little weakness of blood, it's over.
Let's go down to North Carolina. Bill, what's up?
Hey, man, I mean, I love y'all's show, but every time Voss gets on there, man, it's a freaking screw-up. He's a bumbling idiot, man, a mucus-filled, cough-secreting faggot. He never says anything, man. He just sits there and starts the story, and you know it's bullshit from the time he opens his mouth.
Yeah, they're all lies. They're all lie stories. What are you delivering now?
Excuse me?
What are you delivering? You're in your car.
Delivering?
Yes.
I cannot hear you very well. I'm actually not delivering anything.
I guess you did hear me, stupid.
He's delivering justice. He's a police officer.
Oh, you're a police officer in North Carolina? What's the crime where you live? Somebody rings your doorbell and runs?
I can't hear him at all.
I can't hear him?
No, not at all.
Why?
Sounds like he's in the background as opposed to being
outside.
Yeah,
that blows.
What are you doing, Bill? Chasing those Duke boys?
There is a problem. You got to tell, what's his name? You know, when we do have a guest on that mic, they can't hear the phones. That sucks.
Maybe he's investigating. I understand that.
Did you really say the Allman Brothers?
Just stepped on. Just stomped on. Jim's in the middle of a joke on that cop from North Carolina, and Opie just trots, just trotting on it like through a daisy field.
What
stomping.
Happened?
Oh.
Was it a good one?
He was halfway through it.
I don't remember.
It wasn't like where you start and kind of, you know, you're tripping up. Jim was halfway through that
gag. But
I told
you, he's roadkill today. We're just going to keep...
That could have been one that got us into fifth gear.
That would have been a good one.
We're just going to keep running him over.
That would have been a good one.
I'm sorry.
Look at Opie's big footprint on your head.
I was distracted because we...
I feel like Charles Grodin in King Kong.
I'm sorry.
What are you smelling yourself?
What do you smell
you
your armpits?
Off? Are you stinky today?
No, not at all.
No, someone want to know if you said, who are the Almond or that. Almond Brothers?
The Almond Brothers?
I didn't say the Almond. I said the Almond Brothers. Almond.
Almond?
The Walnut
I didn't
Brothers.
Put a D on the end. I said Almond.
Almond.
Yeah, the Almond Brothers.
All right. The guy thought you might have had a D.
He was hoping Rich said that.
And then Almond Brothers. It's like I talk about North Carolina. Every time I've been on, I've been funny. I always bring something. You know, enough already.
Rich gets very upset. It's always about him. He gets upset when people mock him on the... Look at this. Mike Ryan from Jersey. Boss, clear your throat. Yeah, we've been watching the Chicago Fire on TV. They put this out yet?
Boy, they'll do anything to get people's minds off that basketball team they have out there. They haven't won a game yet. They're doing really bad.
For the Bulls?
Yeah, they stink. That was kind of a good line.
No, it wasn't.
It wasn't a bad line. If I delivered it better and it had a better punchline, it would have been good. No, it would have been good. It had potential.
It bugged him about the guy calling him.
I know. Why do you look at... They hate me. They hate all of us.
I don't know.
You're the only one that takes it personally.
I know. I'm sorry.
One guy.
I know, but he's a cop in North Carolina. He's a big rich.
Well, actually, there were a lot of guys, but I figured he represented everybody. So don't worry about it.
No,
do you want to read the feedback? It's not too pretty.
Well, what the hell? What do you mean it's not too
so
pretty?
I'm so kidding. Will you shut up?
What am I supposed to do?
He's kidding. Elvira, he's kidding.
One guy gets you. It's amazing.
I was kidding.
All right.
You ought to listen to Bonnie, man. You are an asshole.
I love listening to kids talk. I'm going to be an astronaut. I'm going to be a movie star.
I'm going to be a pilot.
I'm going to be a pilot. Fast forward 15 years, the same kids working at the deli, you know.
Gardening supply store.
Gardening supply store, used car salesman. But all kids, I'm going to be a professional baseball player.
Yeah, but you don't see the part where the uncle walks in the room and ruins that dream. I have really nothing. I swear to God, thank God for my ear. Thank God.
That's
if
the
I
only...
didn't have this left ear,
your ear
has
become
God,
a crutch.
I'm
ear like, full of stench.
I'm like Daniel Day-Lewis with my left ear. Is that his name? Is that his name?
Yes!
Was that his name? Yes.
It was pretty funny, actually. I don't know why we didn't laugh.
Oh, it was very funny. I just wanted him to have back-to-back.
Is that his name?
Well, because it was a good reference. And it was funny, but you guys, see, that's the problem.
I don't...
You know what the problem is?
What?
If you don't laugh at a good one like that, then the people listening go, well, that's not funny.
Right.
Because they think that you got to laugh in the studio. Yeah.
Did you hear my Omen line go down the toilet before when I did the bend girl hang
himself?
That was
a good, that was a great line.
No, but
we're
I said,
just in,
no, no, the girl, the what? Stop the flow.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding.
But see, I've had like five good lines, but you guys have no energy today. You're not giving...
What? No. We had a lot of energy until I saw your face outside the studio.
No, I'm saying, you know.
Here comes the showstopper.
No, no, listen.
And you haven't had five good lines.
Yes, I definitely did.
Can you
had
at least
four.
Say that confidently? You did.
Okay, maybe four. All right, we'll settle on three.
Yeah. Negotiation.
You're thinking it's Jew bargaining technique.
Five lines, three lines, four.
Three, but you got to give me two towards the next appearance.
I'll gladly pay you two lines for an appearance today.
Oh, God, am I a fucking great character.
Oh. At least he's confident.
Well, I don't know if he's confident. He's confident right now. Wait till the next bomb and then see how not confident he is. All right.
Now, do we know what we're doing here? We got Rich. He's going to get a fingerful of that behind-the-ear stench. What he will do then is put it, wave it under your nose.
Not
so you
wave
can smell
it.
Hold it. Yeah.
What's his name?
Paul. It will be like wafted, so it wafts under his nose. Hold it under his nose. You gotta sniff.
He looks like Mr. Kaputnik's son from Mad Comic Books. There's that line. That's not a bad.
First of all, his name is Roger Kaputnik, and he's a great character. But I don't recognize that. That's a very obscure reference.
Yeah, I read Mad growing up, and I could not possibly.
You don't remember Mr.
Roger Kaputnik? If he was an older guy with white hair, I might have recognized as Roger Kaputnik.
Yeah.
But the son.
If he had a son.
Does he look like the grown-up kid from Family Circus?
Yeah.
It's just a very, very obscure references. He looks like Dagwood Bumstead's third nephew from an abusive marriage he was involved in before the cartoon.
Third panel, 1968, February 12th, New York Times.
You look like a kid Beale Bailey molested.
Wow. Family Circle, that's
that could be
one.
The most obscure reference ever on this program.
Yeah, that was pretty obscure.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Save that for the comic book convention. I mean,
you know what he looks like.
Private Pyle!
Little bit.
Yeah, a little bit.
All right, well, you know what?
So it'll be wafted under his nose.
Can I say hi to Jim in Jersey first, though?
Oh, yeah?
Here we go.
Yeah, Jim, go ahead.
Can't even get the rules out today.
I know.
Yo, listen, Voth is killing a show today.
No, he's not.
Oh, he's killing the show today.
You're out of your mind.
Tackling little kid today.
I am. Because it's funny. There's funny stuff going on.
That's right. I can't help it.
When you hear funny stuff, you got to laugh, man. It's giving it back.
Let's see. Voss makes Lady Di sound like Lenny Bruce.
Oh, Jesus.
I still read Mad, and Voss is an idiot. He finally has a great line, and he completely blows it. Wow. Hey, Voss, you explained your jokes well.
Wow, I'm getting a lot of write-ins. That's pretty good.
It is good. They all know you.
I got more write-ins than Nader.
Rich, The Legacy. What's up, Rich?
Yeah, guys. I learned that Rich Voss needs a director to make him funny.
Oh.
Do I?
That means we all get the phone calls later. You don't think I was that bad on the show today, do you?
Well, you're not going to kill every day.
Voss is very funny.
That doesn't matter. I'm not going to kill every day.
We all know you're funny.
It doesn't matter. My job was to bring air juice in today.
Air juice?
What the hell is air juice?
What is air juice?
From my ear.
You said air juice.
What's an air juice?
Air.
Is that kind of like an heirloom, but that's when you leave that gunk for your kids?
Ear. Ear, whatever.
Michael O.J. Jordan, his air juice.
George from Jersey. Anyone?
Thought it was funny.
That's good. George. See, the guy's laughing. It was good.
Oh, good. Thank you. I got one from the caller.
Just because we're in a coma in the studio doesn't mean someone out there is not laughing. And Joe from Greenwich, Connecticut. I learned that Voss's next appearance will be in My Left Ear, co-starring Daniel Day-Lewis. Mm.
They, laptops, though, how many people really put them in their laps when they use them?
It's called a laptop.
A laptop.
Not if you're Rich Voss, it's a laptop.
I gotta get a laptop.
You know what?
So when I eat tortilla chips.
You know what? I hate to do this to Voss, but we gotta teach him a lesson.
Guys, you guys talk. I gotta find something.
He was really bothered that he didn't have a good appearance on our show yesterday, or 2 days ago.
Really
but
bothered. His bad appearances are good. Like, yeah, I think people like when he kind of falls on his face.
There are people that hate myself, Anthony, Norton, but we don't care and we don't take it personally.
Yeah, it's
you know? We know enough people like what we do on the show that it works. Simple as that. Voss is one of these guys, one person says he stinks and he can't handle it.
Yeah.
And we've been trying to tell him, you can't listen to the fans.
Even though it's a lot more people than that. But it's Voss is one of the funniest guys in the business, and he just worries about one or two dumbbells who don't like him. It's like, who cares, dude?
So he posted on our message board, whackbag.com.
He did? What's Voss's name on the message board?
Voss.
Oh, there you go. It's all about him.
Also, opianthony.net, another great message board. They're not getting plugs, enough plugs.
Opianthony or just Opianthony?
Opianthony. Here's Voss. Voss is on the phone. This is what Voss wrote overnight. Last night at 11 o'clock. Here's the deal. When I go into...
You got to do it in the Voss voice.
Well, then you got to do it, because I don't...
No. Just do this.
No, I'm...
Do an impression so people have to drink.
No, I don't do it.
All right, then just
voice.
I do some fine impressions on the show, but Voss is not one of them.
But you just got to do this with your... Just put spit in your teeth.
No, I can't.
No?
You want to do it yourself? You can get
No. Go ahead.
Just picture Voss's voice.
All right.
I can't.
Picture, if you will.
Here's the deal. When I go...
Funny post.
No, you got to do it as Voss.
No, go ahead.
Jimmy?
Read along.
I don't do Voss. Ant does Voss.
It's easy. Just spit in your teeth.
Why don't you read the line, and then, you know, Anthony will do it.
No, go ahead. Just
read.
All right. Here's the deal. When I go into O&A, it's to hang out. If I come up with something funny, good, and if I don't, oh well. I am not be interviewed. There's Voss for you.
I am not be interviewed.
Yeah, it's not like it has an edit feature that you can read it over and edit your post if there's any.
I'm certainly not
problems.
Helping him out today. I am not be interviewed.
He probably meant B. Arthur.
So I like most other. Holy crap. Listen to this sentence. I am not be interviewed, comma, so I, like most other comics, will throw shit out when I can. I don't step on other people when they are talking, so I get stuff in when I can. When there are other guests on and I think they should be trash, that's where I try to shine. Now for Kid Nig. I guess that's another member of the board.
He's addressing individuals now.
Oh, yeah.
He's obsessed.
Dude, this guy was on a network TV show for 2 seasons, and one lousy poster on whackbed.com got to him.
Although, let me jump in. I don't mind addressing a guy. If a guy posts bad about you or whatever, you address it, that's cool. But it's like to really let it bother you. I love, I always answer real hate.
Well, this is the funny part about this. You read this post and he's trying to act like it, you know, it doesn't really bother him. But you can tell he's just so bothered.
It says, oh well.
Lately. Yeah.
Whenever you say, oh well, you're bothered.
So, now for Kid Nig. I am not sure if you are the same spook that use to post.
Use S-E?
That use to post.
Use to post?
Yeah.
Wait, how is that spelled?
U-S-E.
U-S-E.
Now for Kid Nig.
T-O?
Yeah, use to.
Not used to.
Yeah.
Use to.
Use to. Now for Kid Nig. I'm not sure if you are the same spook that use to post on the other board, because I can't smell through my computer.
Oh, my God.
He's really pissed off.
He's funny on the message board.
If you don't think I'm funny, that's fine. You won't come to any of my shows, and that will be one less primate that the club won't have to worry about.
Holy Jesus, Voss.
And we tried to calm him down at the show. Like, dude, not every appearance is going to be great. And actually, he gave some great radio that day with the ear thing and stuff, and he had some great lines. I see that you called me a hack. I will give you the benefit of the doubt and not get too mad. Maybe when you were... typing, your bottom lip was hitting the wrong keys and you didn't mean to spell hack.
Holy. Oh, man.
Perfect.
Cause Would a hack be writing for the Oscars? He is writing for the Oscars this year. So he has to throw that in there.
Yes, he is.
Or would a hack...
Chris Rock, who he's writing for, will be happy to hear these things he's written on the message board. Stupid-ass Voss.
Oh, we'll make sure that Chris Rock gets a copy of this, because that's what friends are for.
Send it to Chris Rock.
Cause, would a hack be writing for the Oscars, or would a hack make 12 grand last week, or be on network TV 2 years in a row?
Oh, my God. I can't believe he's writing this stuff.
Somebody called me a hack.
So maybe you just made a mistake. Kind of like your mom when the load that created you trickled out of her ass and slid into her Brillo hair smelly catcher's mitt. She calls her drink ticket.
Sounds like the best part of you dribbled out of your mama's ass into her Brillo catcher's mitt and she calls her drink ticket. Got to be Sergeant Voss.
Wow. He is an angry Jew.
And then he finishes up by saying, just a mistake she should have wiped. Wow. It happens to the best of us, Voss.
Kidding! How tall are you?
He is so bothered.
Oh, could you just picture those stubby little fingers just flailing away on the keyboard, all angry?
No, it's this. It's Peck.
Oh, he's a
Peck.
Hunting. Where's the Peck. A? Where's the A? A? Let's go with the T. T, okay.
So what did Kid Nig write?
I don't know what I don't know what Kid Nig probably just said that he had an awful appearance and doesn't like him.
Well, there are people
that don't like all of us.
Somebody'll go to the message board.
We have our haters out there.
Yeah, you get them. So what?
Yeah.
Norton ruins the show. You guys are good. Why do you have? I just address them, and you don't let it bother you. It's numerically, it's going to happen. So what?
Well, you do ruin the show.
But... No, I'm not saying I don't know, but I'm just trying to say. But
oh, we just don't know how to. Tell
no,
you.
But I don't.
We
really,
just don't know how to tell you off air, so we might as well just kind of.
No,
make,
by
we might as well just make believe it's a bid, and we'll just make believe. That
no, but oh, by
for the air, we'll just.
But
oh
by,
my God, why would you even say something like that?
What?
Because that'll get them like thinking that maybe it really is.
Well, no, it won't.
Maybe it's time he, you know. You don't reach between the lines.
You don't understand. I'm here to pick up a check.
Very good. Join the club.
And you know what, dude? You want to throw me off the show? As long as I have the downtown on December 23rd.
That's all you need.
516-293-7700. As I leave the Opie and Anthony show, you can hear my speech at the downtown December 23rd in Long Island.
And, of course, you could go to eatabullet.com, right?
Absolutely. Pick up old Jimmy Norton CD.
I think Eric... I saw him run over to the computer. I think he's looking for Kid Nig's email that or post that got Voss so angered.
Hot under the collar.
It's got him so Steve under the collar that he is writing racist remarks. Writing all kinds of racist remarks, really busting apart the Jewish stereotype that Jews really aren't tolerant of the African-American people. Just instantly goes to... Yeah. The Voss playing the race card.
Don't be mad at me just because we made movies that made fools out of you in the 70s and you allowed it. Jesus, Voss.
And I'm getting a communique. Voss sent in a song that he wrote.
He did?
Yeah.
I didn't know Voss was a songwriter also.
Music?
Yeah, he... Oh, God.
Wow.
Where's Voss's song, Opie?
He is multi-talented, Rich Voss.
I had a great idea, but I can't find Voss's song.
Aw.
Booby Man writes in, Opie, give Voss a break. He had to answer his phone while he was typing.
Oh, that's true. Poopsie might have been there. Cage says there's even a picture on Whackbag of Voss typing on his laptop with his tiny little hand. Did he really call it a laptop? He is adult. A laptop.
Well,
Voss doesn't know the difference between a mini disc and an iPod player.
What's this?
That's the Voss thing.
That's it?
That was it.
Short. That short, and Voss had that long explanation? Kid Africa, his name is. I guess Voss was calling him Kid Nig. Loyalty doesn't make Voss funny. The thing that's funny about Voss is just how unfunny he is. The good thing about him is that he's a hack and he knows it. Now that...
See, I gotta defend.
I completely disagree with.
Yeah, I gotta defend Voss. I mean, yeah, we joke about how unfunny he is, but when it comes down to it, when he's on a stage, he's really funny. His act is really, really funny.
Voss isn't a hack.
No. Mike from Philly, what did you learn on the show today?
Yeah, Voss doesn't like people who type with their bottom lip, and his new CD is going to be released on Panzerfaust Records.
Ooh, hey, that's not bad
Very
either.
Good.
Bad. Still not going to be able to get in with those tats.
I really care when I'm dead. I've died so many times on stage. But who cares?
The fact is, you do not die on stage.
I know, I don't.
You only die on the radio.
I don't. No. I've been reading the boards, and 33 out of 36 liked me last time.
All right, really?
Yeah. You're obsessed with that. Those boards.
Oh,
they hate everything.
Huh?
They'll pick apart everything.
Oh, I live on
Anthony and I could go home knowing we just had a great show, and then you go on those message boards, and they'll still pick it apart and find something they just didn't like. You know, there was 2 minutes there that I thought the guys were really just not on top of their game.
Yeah. I was reading the boards last night. I was reading a little. Actually, I think I posted a couple of times.
Uh-huh.
It was, did you like the old NEW show better than you like this show? They throw questions out for each other on the board. So I'm reading it, and you know, some people are commenting how they loved the old show, they liked it better. We had better. One guy goes, "We had better guests
on the old show."
On the old show, and he finds himself listening to the old MP3s of the old show instead of the replay of this show. And I had to remind him. Great guests when we first started at NEW. People forget when we first started there. They're thinking of all the good stuff we did and all the stuff that's on MP3 that you could download. That wasn't the entire time we were there and every bit that we've ever done. How about Kenny Wayne Shepherd as one of our guests?
Sheryl Crow.
With these great guests. How about when we had a break to play Do You Think I'm Sexy? If you want my body and you think I'm sexy, when we had to stop and play that. Because we were playing music. They forget the first few months we were at NEW.
It was about the first year.
About a year.
Basically, what they're listening to is 4 years of our greatest hits.
Right.
We've only done 3 months here at XM Satellite.
And I think our first 3 months here blows away the first 3 months at NEW.
Oh, without a doubt.
And it's only going to get better and as time goes by. But these morons get on there and just start critiquing it like we've been, you know, like we were at NEW. We're still at NEW, but this is the show we're doing now. We just changed.
No. It's a work in progress.
Not only that, you think of it this way. We were off the air for a couple of years. Now, if we were on the air during that time, we would have changed because our show is constantly changed over time.
I believe it's evolving.
Evolving, mm-hmm. Right. And you wouldn't have really noticed it because we would have been on the air for those 2 years. It's like watching somebody, and you see them, you don't notice their hair is getting longer or something. But if you don't see them for a couple of years and they never got a haircut, you'd go, wow, the guy got long hair.
Wow, he really changed.
Yeah. It's one of those things where if we were on the air, you wouldn't have noticed the change. But in 2 years, we changed as people. We have different opinions about life, things. And we discuss maybe different topics in different ways on the show.
I'm not as angry anymore.
Right. It's just the way it is.
And people are, slow down. You know, and the reason I'm not angry as much anymore is because I'm happy here. I was absolutely miserable at WNEW.
Yeah.
I felt like they just didn't get our show and the potential it had, even though we got syndicated and stuff, but it took forever to get syndicated, and they still didn't respect us or what we did. Even though we were getting huge ratings all over the country, we were still being treated like second-class citizens, mm-hmm. You know? And I took out my frustration on the management and the people we worked with and the equipment, because no one cared.
Uh-huh.
You know, here they seem to, believe it or not, they seem to get it a lot more than the old place. So I'm not going to fake the anger.
No.
I'm actually happy.
Someone else posted, they didn't care. I liked when they didn't care if they got fired or not. And then used Sex for Sam as an example. It's like, excuse me, and I even posted on this one. I said, excuse me, there was never a point where we didn't care if we got fired.
The day before you guys got fired, we were supposed to do that tour, right? You know, it was going to be like in the
Voss was setting up this huge comedy tour.
Colin, Patrice, Norton. Yeah. So the day before you get, I go out and buy a new Mercedes, right? And the next day you get fired, and I'm sitting with a $450 car payment and nothing.
Yeah,
nothing.
And me and Opie are high fiving each other, going, "Yeah, we did it. We got fired, just like we wanted to."
you know, in the long run, it helped us, and we said that all along when we were off the air. We had to get past the fact that we weren't going to do radio for over 2 years, but Anthony and I talked a lot saying, you know, eventually this is only, believe it or not, going to make us bigger. That's just how this crap works.
We never try to get fired. Jesus. You insane?
Norton and I would steward nights. That was the depression.
That was one of the tamer things we've done. Yeah. Believe it or not, and you go, "What? Are you kidding?" We could list a bunch of things that we should have got fired for, but we didn't.
Yep.
But even the message boards. I mean, you'll get some good posts. I mean, Cringe usually has good
cringehumor.net.
Yeah, I think
there are some cool people. Actually, the majority of the people are pretty cool on the message boards, but there's a few of them that just either they really don't get it, or they're just plain stupid people. Uh-huh. Like, there are some real morons that post, and you're like, what are you? You're a complete idiot.
I used to read the message boards from Last Comic Standing, and when we did one show where it was a roast. We roasted Jay Moore. It was a roast. And people on the message boards go, they were kind of mean. He was sarcastic.
It's a roast,
you fucking idiot.
Yeah, don't you get the definition of a roast?
You know,
when you're being completely sarcastic on this show, and you say something, and someone posts like you meant what you said.
Yeah, the whole, it's only 50,000, Jim Norton.
Yeah. You know, hey, Jim,
maybe 50,000 isn't a lot for you, but
that
for
is
us
a perfect example.
I'm like, are you kidding? It was the sarcasm. Obviously, $50,000 is a lot of money.
That's the joke. You know, Jimmy's sitting there complaining that he lost out on $50,000.
He was supposed to get a huge raise just before we got fired.
And Opie goes, relax, Jim, it's only 50 grand.
It's no big deal.
Meaning, you know, that's a lot of money.
I'm just busting
his
balls, you know?
And somebody writes, you know, Opie shouldn't say $50,000 isn't a lot of money. It makes him look. Like you, and you got to respond. You got to respond with, you are the dumbest son of a bitch I've ever read from.
You do. You
That's why you can't
you
take,
have to.
You can't take the message board seriously.
Well,
you
can't, but there's certain people. You know, there's one guy, Kid Nigger, Africa. I don't remember his name.
Kid Africa.
We used to fight back and forth all the time, you know.
Yeah.
And he's probably just some little, you know, fat, dumpy guy that doesn't leave the house, doesn't get laid, you know, and he sits there in his life.
And you're getting all pissed off, slamming the keyboard.
Out of my mind.
Dude, I don't get pissed off anymore. It used to drive me nuts. It's funny, opieanthony.net, they've been begging me to promote them more and you know, hey, we noticed you haven't been on the board lately, you know, so I'm like, might as well go on and see what these guys are up to. It's been a while. And right away, there's like two or three threads just trashing me. I'm like, well, all right, I'll see you guys later.
That's what they do.
How can the word trash you? Your name is the title.
It's amazing. It's a whole thread about
what they do.
What I do and don't do for the radio show. People don't understand what it takes to put this together at all. We all understand our roles.
They
trust
hear
me.
It coming out of the speaker, and that's it. There's no clue as to what each of our roles are, how important everyone is, how the show couldn't be the show without each person in their place doing what they do. But, yeah, you'll read on the message board and just go, shut up.
And you're so
uninformed. Cool.
It used to drive me nuts because people don't understand all the stuff I do behind the scenes that makes this show, okay? Yeah. That's one of my big roles as far as the Opie and Anthony program goes. But like Ant said, they only understand what comes through the speaker.
Right. So the organization of the show.
So if I'm not funny enough, all of a sudden I'm like, you know, some drag on the radio program or something.
Right.
Yeah, but you know what? Nowadays, without, you know, instead of reviews this and that, you know, big actors and musicians are going to message boards too.
Absolutely know it.
Everybody is like, you know, for movies, you know, probably Dustin Hoffman sitting home going, I don't believe they just said this about me.
I did
Marathon.
Yeah, of course, because we're all human and we all have egos. And
there are
some
people that acknowledge it and other people don't, but you know they all read them.
You got to. You got to read them because it's a review almost. So you're almost like drawn into it. You
Kevin
know?
Smith
so,
has his own website, View Askew. .com, and he's got a message board on there, and he posts on it, and you know, they did a whole goof on it on Jay and Silent Bob, where they were goofing on the fact that their fans just tool them. You are fucking clown shoes. This is hysterical, man. And they'll pound you, but you know these celebrities just pop on and start reading. And
but with all that said, I believe, you know, pretty much everything should be on the message boards, you know? I mean, Howard Stern has a message board, and, you know, you trash him or you're a fan of this show, and you go on there, you're instantly banned. We just don't do that type of thing, you know?
We don't have a message board, is what it is.
Right.
Officially, we don't run a message board.
Right.
You know? So it's not like we're
going on. We let the fans do it.
But you got to admit, they are.
And there's message boards that come and go because, you know, if it there's things that make one message board more popular than the other.
Well, there's three that I go to.
There's
Cringe.
A lot more than that. There's a wowfans.com, there's cringehumor.net, yeah. opieanthony.net,
and each one of these
whackbag.com. There was Save Opie and Anthony. I don't even know if that's around anymore.
There are some of these websites that these guys run, and they have their own rules and regulations on them as to what they want added on there and what they won't allow and language they won't allow, things like that. And that's their prerogative, you know? It's their message board. I love when people go on there and go, why was my post deleted? Freedom of speech. It's not freedom of speech. It's this guy's message board. Yeah. And it's up to him what he wants or doesn't want on it. People are so quick to pull out that freedom of speech. You pay the bandwidth charges, asshole.
Right.
And then we'll see. Then you could say what should or shouldn't be on there.
I had a message board on my website. That lasted a day, like the first three posts. Go fuck yourself. You stink. I want to bang your daughters. You know, it's coming down.
Of course.
It's coming down.
I can't deal with this.
This is coming right down.
All from Jimmy Norton.
Kill yourself.
See, Anthony and I have been doing this internet thing for... We were one of the first radio shows. We really were. I mean, we were way in the beginning when Ant was updating...
I invented the internet.
Honestly, when not many people had computers in their homes yet. And this is only going back like 10, not even 10 years.
It's when people still had like those old 486s in their house. And, you know, you watched pictures scroll down and it took forever to download a little piece of pornography.
Still does on mine.
Yeah, we got excited because we had a real popular show in Boston and our website back then, if we got 100 hits, we're like, oh my God, wow, this is unbelievable. Yeah. Now we get... Foundry Music gets, I don't even know anymore, but a ridiculous amount of hits every day.
We were videotaping stuff, putting video clips up on the websites, which back then was just unheard of. There was no compression, so these files were giant. I got a bandwidth charge 1 month for like $5,000 back then, and I was making nothing. I lost my mind. I did not know, because who knew, you know? I had this server. And I didn't read any fine print. I'm like, I'll put stuff up on this website and people can download it. And I'm taking video of these girls that are coming into the studio doing things and uncompressed. I'm taking uncompressed video and putting it up for people to download. And they're downloading it and just, I mean, bandwidth up the ass. And I get this bill and I lost my mind. I called the guy at the server and was just like, you got to help me out here. I can't pay this. I can't do this.
You got to help me out and tell me what uncompressed means.
Oh, no. Call Lady Di. She's a computer expert.
No.
She'll help you out.
Are we going to get Lady Di on the phone?
We keep getting her answering machine.
All right. Well, I mean, it could wait.
Maybe she's laying by the phone with the vacuum cleaner going and her shoe off, a little askew.
Oh, my God. Very good. So, but write whatever you want.
Have fun.
It used to get to me a lot more than it does now. I know it gets to Voss. That's why
not as much as, you know, after the last...
Ben's Roy asks, what did you learn on the show today?
Hey, guys. Today I learned that Jews with rabbit teeth make good fill-in hosts.
Yeah,
yes,
you know,
Rich Voss, man.
Yeah, Voss gets a bad rap at times, but, man, you killed today. He kills on stage. We like to abuse him, but, man, you brought the funny today, Rich.
Stepped up. Had a good time with Rich on the show today.
DVD, richvoss.com.
richvoss.com.
richvoss.com.